What is up, YouTube? Doing a ginormous project this week on my MIDI lathe. We took the biggest 5-quart bucket that I found, had some scrap wood, and decided that, you know, I'm pretty much getting back into the rhythm of these projects and decided, you know what, we're going to do something bigger this time. So, got this 5-quarter, took some dark resin. I've never done a dark or a black resin project before and decided, you know what, I want to see what kind of cool colors we can get out of this. And here you go with my floating waste block that is now floating on the top of the resin, which was not good, but ended up having a really good cast with it, as you can see here. Really happy the way this casted. I'm getting more and more professional with using this resin, which is always good. Knocked on it for good luck. Had a tannin on the top of it that I needed to put in so the blank would sit in the resin well. So ended up chipping that off. You didn't see that in the project, but overall really happy the way it casted. So put the faceplate on it, and then we started to turn it down to get everything nice and even as we usually do. And you can see those good cool ribbons coming off, or that good shavings coming off the back of this thing. Had an initial problem with the faceplate, and you won't really be able to see it here in the project, but I had to hurry up and make a mortise for this thing, because I put the faceplate on, and where you saw where I chipped off that initial tannin, I didn't have a really good attachment point, and it was kind of giving me some issues while it was wobbling on the lathe. So the faceplate wasn't absolutely secure, which was unfortunate in this project. So once I got that back piece done, I was really in a rush to hurry up and turn this down as quickly as possible, because my biggest fear was it was going to detach from the faceplate and then fly off the lathe, and then I was going to be in a world of fucking hurt. So here we are, just got everything nice and smoothed down the way I wanted it to, hit it with that chisel, and now I'm basically trying to make the smoothest strokes that I can with the chisel, because I didn't want to have this thing fly off the lathe like I was worried about. And thank goodness we ended up having a successful mortise built before it flew off the lathe. So got it on the chuck here, everything nice and reversed, and here's me trying to hurry up and attach it in this cool little montage here. So boom, we're attached, and you can see the wobble in it, so now we're just basically evening everything out of it. And there was a giant dent in the bucket when, I don't know if you saw that in the beginning portion of the video, but there was a giant dent in it, so we had to remove a lot of material, and you'll see that here in a little bit, and it's just wobbly as hell. But check out those cool shavings. Who doesn't love that about woodworking, by the way? That's got to be like my favorite thing, is like, if you're a woodworker or you do wood turning, when you finally get good shavings, that's a fun part of it. And you can see here, my hands are like covered in like Spider-Man webbing. And I pushed the camera back so you could kind of see that effect of it. And it looks really, really cool. I'm like, look at that, it's just shooting everywhere. By the way, wear a respirator when you do this. And I wear a respirator when I wood turn, even though you see it kind of hanging there on the wall there. I had another one that I was wearing. But yes, definitely wear a respirator when you're doing this, because you're gonna suck in some fumes, unfortunately. So once I got everything kind of evened out the way I want it, hit it with the skew, even though it kind of doesn't look a little even by the judging of that. So came back with my round carbide tool, and now I'm just basically evening everything out, even though there's still a little bit of wobble on it, getting these good shavings off of it, which look amazing. So bam, there it is, everything is nice and even, or at least it appears that way. But on the lathe, while I'm gouging it out, you can see some wobble here, but it really isn't a problem until a little bit later in the project. So once we got that all down, now I'm just gouging it out, trying to make everything nice and even. And I probably should have took more material off of it. I don't know if that's just the unevenness of the blank or the fact that I'm pushing the weight limit on my MIDI lathe, because this isn't a giant lathe. It's basically a middle of the road type of lathe for projects. This is probably the max amount of material that I can put on it without getting that crazy wobble. And if you've been watching my channel for any amount of time, you know that I've done some larger projects where the thing just wobbled crazy all over the workbench. But That was mostly due just to the unevenness of the material. That's why it's so important to do that. So, middle portion of the project, not too difficult to gouge out. Still getting pretty good shavings off of it. I did have a little bit of chatter once I started getting off toward the edges, only because I would gouge out the wooden portions of the bowl, but once it, you know, switched materials from wood to epoxy, you could really feel that in the chisel, and that was a bit of a problem. It didn't fly off the lathe from what I can remember, but you definitely felt that uneasiness as you're gouging closer and closer toward the edges of the wall of the bowl. And this is a little bit later where we start to experience a little bit of that, but still getting good shavings off of this particular piece, which I was really happy about. And my biggest fear, as I am always doing, is the fact that I'm going to chip out the side of the bowl and it's just going to be basically worthless. So wanted it to do a very nice translucent look to it, and the camera is getting shot with all of this stuff that's coming off of the lathe. And here you can see where I flinched a little bit, and you can kind of see the lines of the inner portions of the bowl, and I'm getting a lot of just different material between the wood and the epoxy, and it's just kicking back on me a little bit, which was a bit of a pain in the ass because it freaked me the hell out, and I really thought I was going to chip out the side of the bowl. But got everything sanded down real good, and then we just hit it with that wood wax, and it looks freaking amazing. You can see the translucency in that epoxy. It's that nice dark black look, but that translucent using the liquid dye versus that of like the powder made it really, really cool. So you get this cool like night look to it, and it looks amazing. I'm going to start using this darker material or darker resin in the future because I already have a project in mind that I want to do, but it looks amazing. Really happy the way this turned out. And here it is right on the back. You can see everything nice and translucent, but you still get that cool dark color. So hope you guys enjoyed the project. I had a lot of fun doing this one. A little bit bigger piece, really getting hanging into the rhythm of doing these epoxy projects. So hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget to subscribe, and I will catch you guys in the next project. All right, peace out, guys. Okay, so project is done. This one turned out absolutely gorgeous. Look at that. So I used the biggest bowl that I had, was able to turn this down really fucking smooth, but it looks awesome. Translucent, just a large, it's not even a bowl, it's more of a dish. These aren't bowls, they're dishes, but it looks really good. So look at that, all my fingerprints getting all over this beautiful thing. So hope you liked it, hope you enjoyed the project, something a little bit different, kind of, sort of, not really, but don't forget to subscribe over here, and I'll see you guys in the next project. All right. Bye, guys. Bye.